welcome out to episode 319 of The Good, The Bad, and The Geeky. Before we get started with today's show, which is a bit different anyway, a few things. Science fiction, if you didn't know, created a whole set of worlds for us to dive into. Go deep into Star Trek with a panel of hosts starting from the very beginning. Learn about each episode and Trekkie history, all while having fun with a brand new podcast called It's All Been Trek Before. Available on iTunes and Stitcher. It's all been done anyway, so check it out at iabdpresents.com. That's right, IABD Presents is one of our sponsors of our show. We're part of the IABD Presents Network, so check them out. Check them out where? iabdpresents.com. Booyah. Also, packratcomics.com. Packratcomics.com has more information on how to order stuff from them online. Their pull lists, graphic novels, t-shirts, board games, and much more. I love that place. I love those guys dearly. Please check them out. It's packratcomics.com for more information. Personally, I love their social media pages too, because they have all those new comic book day videos and they crack me the fuck up. And yeah. Well, and last but not least, go ahead and if you haven't checked out the fan-made Rocky and Bullwinkle podcast, The Magically Unauthorized Misadventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle, go to gbgpresentspod.com. Produced by my very own D4K Studios, features a fun little romp. The first season does, at least. I mean, I think the second season could be fun, too. We haven't produced it yet, but it's a fun little romp recorded live at Pack Rat, of all things. And it's really great, you guys. It's really a lot of fun. I hope you guys check it out. Okay, so now this episode. This episode's a little different than normal, so I apologize, but this episode, you know, is really just saying farewell to 2016. And, you know, 2016's been a not great year if you've been a geek or a nerd or someone who just has loved media like I do. We lost a lot of great people like Gary Marshall, Doris Roberts, Kenny Baker. You know, there are a lot of people we've lost. And granted, some of these people are a little bit older. But we've lost some, too, that felt like they were robbed from us a little bit. David Bowie being one of them. Even though David Bowie was much older, the fact that that cancer is what took him was heartbreaking. Prince was one that just, wow, completely shocked us. And the two that really have hit me the hardest, and granted it's very fresh on this, but Carrie Fisher, Star Wars. You know, I grew up watching Star Wars, and matter of fact, Star Wars was one of those things where I became obsessed with, like, the making of how it was done and all the characters and all this and that, and also the actors, because that one guy, he's like, he's not just Han Solo, he's Indiana Jones, right? So, like, what other movies has he done? Oh, American Graffiti. What about her? Oh, that's Debbie Reynolds' daughter. Well, who's Debbie Reynolds? Debbie Reynolds is the girl from Singin' in the Rain? No. And then you start, who's Mark Hamill? Well, at the time, Mark Hamill's Mark Hamill. And then, like, years later, Mark Hamill's the voice of the Joker? OMG! Awesome. But no, seriously, Princess Leia was a character who, she was my first female hero that I loved. And I mean that sincerely. She would get captured, but she could fight for herself. And she didn't take crap from people unless there was no other option. like anybody in really any circumstance. And I just remember I thought it was so awesome at a young age, and I still do now, that, you know, when the boys weren't firing when she thought they were firing, she just grabbed one of their stormtrooper blasters and started firing back. I think she took it from Han Solo, of all things, or Luke. It doesn't matter. But she took it and she fired him, and, you know, because she really is a strong character. And granted, Empire and Jedi made her more of a love interest, but she still was a fighter. She fought for what she believed in. And, you know, it was one of my first examples of really, really seeing a strong female presence on the screen. That just wasn't the love interest. You know, Indiana Jones kind of did that for me as well, but again, I really watched more Star Wars when I was little. Star Trek, as much as I love it, you know, they didn't really have a lot of strong female characters until Next Generation. I mean, not in my opinion. Again, you're talking to the memory of what I watched it with. I'm sure some colleagues of mine will very much correct me, but most women on that show made out with Kirk and or flirted with Kirk, and that was pretty much it. And that's my nostalgia of Star Trek. It was all about the core group anyway: Kirk, Bones, and Spock, and then occasionally Scotty and Sulu and Chekhov and Uhura. But for me, that really was such a big deal. Despite any misgivings that the episode 4 may have for people, it bothered me. It really bothered me. And the way that Debbie Reynolds died a day later was just equally heartbreaking. And granted, there's the joke that Patton Oswalt and others have said that Carrie would have loved it, and she would have actually supported anyone who said it, which was, there's mom upstaging me again. But, Carrie fought hard to live in her life. She had a lot of demons. And it's just heartbreaking. And we lost other very amazing talent, like Gene Wilder, for God's sakes. Granted, Gene is very up in years, and he's been retired for a while. But if that happened, it is devastating. But I wouldn't sit there and go, he still had more talents to give us. I can't say that. It's not like, and see, I'm not trying to. I feel it's horrible to say this anyway. But with someone like that seems to have withdrawn from the public as much, and you don't hear from them as much, doesn't mean they're not doing anything more. But, when they do pass, it's just like they've lived a very full life. But with some people like, Carrie and Bowie, or even Bowie. Bowie was still producing content until he passed away. Prince. These are all people. And, George Michael, for God's sakes. Look, I was one of the people that was making that joke, okay? Because I thought it was funny to an extent. But it's really not. And it's heartbreaking. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. The very next day, you gave it away, and then the next Christmas, he passed away. It's very sad and it's heartbreaking. We lost a lot of people in their 50s and early 60s, which, especially in today's climate, we're used to people dying when they're 70. They had at least another 10, 15 more years left in them, and say we got people like Trump and Clint Eastwood still kicking it about, and you're going, what the hell? It's just heartbreaking. And overall, personally, to me, the only uplifting thing I really feel was my now wife's uncle got a kidney transplant, which is amazing. But we lost a few people that we knew, which was not great. I lost my job. But, oh well, what can you do? Except for try to put your next foot forward and keep moving on. Now, with that being said, we're going to do something a little bit differently here on the show. I used to do it occasionally back in the day, but I don't feel the need to do it that often. But after this week, I feel like we need a palate cleanser moving into 2017. So what you're about ready to hear is my way of signing off for the year. And for those of you who have stuck with me for the past decade on this little podcast, I appreciate it. For those of you who are new to my show, I thank you for your listening and giving a shit, because I know sometimes it's really just almost more of a personal audio blog, odd blog en español. That's bad. I apologize, but I mean, what do you call an audio blog? An audio journal? I don't know. But sometimes this kind of feels like it's just, these are my thoughts on this, these are my thoughts on this. And other times I have awesome people on the show. But, yeah. But thank you very much for sticking with me for as long as you have. And if it's not been that long, I thank you for that, for hopping on the bandwagon and partaking in the conversation that sometimes I have with you guys. If, you know what? Let's let me know. How was your year as a geek and as an individual person? What stuff bummed you out this year? What stuff made you really happy? What stuff what challenges did you face as a geek, you know, in with your fandoms, or you know, as a human being, what tough things did you have to deal with? Please let me know. goodbadgeeky@gmail.com or tweet me at goodbadgeeky. And we might discuss them on the air. If not, it's just nice, you know, I might just privately write you back and we'll just have a little conversation. Nothing wrong with conversation these days, I feel. So, but let's get on to the meat of this episode. The meat of this episode is really just me saying farewell 2016 and offering a bit of a palate cleanser. And here to help me are some friends who, well, you'll see. Take it.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three. Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it. Want to change the world? There's nothing to it.
Hurry up, pilot!
This way, Grandpa.
No life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be. Simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it. Want to change the world. There's nothing to it. There is no life I know. Compare with your imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be.
Hey, I think it'll work.
Of course.
It's a cinch. You know, it may be crazy, but we're gonna do it. The Dueling Cavalier is now a musical.
Hot dog!
Hallelujah!
Woo-hoo! Fellas, I feel this is my lucky day, March 23rd.
Oh, no, your lucky day is the 24th.
What do you mean the 24th?
It's 1:30 already. It's morning.
Yes, and what a lovely morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
We've talked the whole night through.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. Good morning. Good morning. It's great to stay up late. Good morning.
Good morning to you.
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on his way. It's too late to say goodnight.
So good morning. Good morning. Sun.
Swafru. Good morning. Good morning to you and you and you and you. Good morning. Good morning. We gab the whole night through. Good morning. Good morning to you.
Nothing could be grander than to be in Louisiana
in the morning. In the morning, it's great to stay up late. Good morning. Good morning to you.
Might be just as iffy if we was in Mississippi.
When we left the movie show, future wasn't bright. But came the dawn, the show goes on, and I don't want to say good night.
Don't say good morning.
Good morning.
Rainbows are shining through.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
Bonjour.
Lock, 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 lock